next problem here, and this problem is actually to the largest subarray of 0's and 1's. As you can see, this problem was asked me in Amazon, PayTm, Morgan Stanley, and MakeMyTrip interviews. And trust me, I mean, most of the problems here that I'm discussing here, they are the easy level problems. So I'm taking the levels of the problem, which is easy, medium, and hard. Accordingly, I've divided all these problems. Okay, so this is also an easy level problem which is asked in these companies. Now let us look at the background overview of these companies. Okay, so the first background is related to the PayTm. So PayTm is an Indian e-commerce PayTm system, payment system, which is a digital wallet company, and it was founded by Vijay Shekhar Sharma in August 2010, and the office is in Noida, as you can see here. And PayTm is, you know, available in 10 Indian languages. So you can see this is an Indian company. It is working and operated inside India only. And it's, you know, the annual turnover is around, annual revenue is around 814 crores, or around, which is around 1.120 million, or you can say $1.2 billion dollar company. Okay, and the website is paytm.com, as you can see here. And one of the, I mean, everyday life we are using the PayTm applications. Even if you go to buy milk on Mother Dairy stores, still you can do the payments using PayTm. It's a very famous company here in India. Okay, the next company here is Morgan Stanley. As you can see, Morgan Stanley is an American multinational investment bank and a financial services company, which is headquartered at 1585 Broadway. Okay, that is in Manhattan, New York. Fine, which is having a total of 55,000 employees. As you can see, it is a very big company. 55,000 employees, a huge, huge organization, which is over 42 countries, right? And the total revenue is around $37.95 billion in 2016, which is around $38 billion in 2016, and where the operating income is around $8.85 billion, correct? And the third one is MakeMyTrip. So MakeMyTrip is again an Indian company. So it is an Indian online travel company founded in 2000. Which is headquartered in Gurugram here in Delhi, which is Delhi NCR. And it provides online traveling services including flight tickets, domestics, Indian holidays packages, or hotel reservation, railways and bus tickets, etc., etc. Okay, and this is operating around 47 stores in India itself, and they have an office in New York City also. And the total revenue is around 447.62 million. Which is around $4.5 billion and around 3,426 plus employees, approximately near to 3,500 plus employees are working in MakeMyTrip. And the next one is the Amazon. So Amazon is again, you know, it's a very famous company. Everyday basis we are using the Amazon applications as well as the website to buy various stuff online. And this Amazon is an American company, it's an American electronic commerce company, and which is a cloud company which is based in Seattle, Washington also. So this Amazon is having two parts. One is the e-commerce part that we use, and a part of this e-commerce part, they have a software company, or you can say the IT company, which is providing services, which is providing its products, maybe to the cloud computing. They have Amazon SES and so many different applications, so many different things that they are providing. You can just check it out on Google. You'll find that so many other services are part of this one, which is the e-commerce. They have so many business to business, companies, or can say products that they are providing. Okay, so this company, Amazon, is a huge company which is having $177.86 billion. As you can see, apart of all the companies that we have seen till now, this is a huge one, the biggest one, because in 2017 it was having $177.86 billion as the revenue. And the total assets are huge, the net income is also huge, and number of employees this company is having 5,66,000. That is a huge, huge thing, you know. 5,66,000 employees is a huge company, right? And the maximum salaries that people are getting here in India, there are also in Amazon's, because Amazon is giving, you know, very good perks, very good packages to all this, to the people who are working in, you know, IT industries. Fine. Now, this problem, again, as I told you, it is an easy problem here. They are saying, given an array of zeros and ones, and your task is to complete the function max len. We have a function which is max len, max len. This function is there. which is returns the size of the largest array, which is equal number of 0's and 1's. The function maxLength takes two arguments. We have two input arguments here. The first argument is the array A, so it is taking the array A as the first argument. And the second argument is n, that is the size of the array. So here we have an integer n, which is denoting the size of the array. So there are two input arguments to this array, as you can see here. And then they are saying the input, in case of input, the first line T denotes the number of test cases. As you can see, this is common in all the, you know, all the problems that we have seen, that we are giving the number of test cases. And then the T test cases follow, and each test case contains two lines. The first line of each test case is the number of n number n denoting the size of the array, and the second line are n space separated values of the array A. Okay, and in case of output, we are expecting that for each test case output in a new line, the max length of the subarray. So they are expecting that we should give the max length of the subarray. Okay, now let us say, let me give an example of how the input is generally given for this particular case. Here, if I say that the array, so if I say the input, in case of input, the first line is 2, where 2 is denoting the total number of test cases. Okay, so we are going to have 2 test cases. In every case, we explain that we have 2 test cases. That is just for example purposes only. And then we have, if we have 4, that means 4 is the size of the first array, which is having the 4 integer values, which are 0, 1, 0, 1. So that means the first array is having the value 0, 1, 0, and 1. Okay, all these values are in binaries only. And the second line, the next one, next test case is having the value 5, which is denoting the array as 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, like this. Okay, so this is the next array, like this. Okay, now, in the output, this is the input, how the input is given. Now, in case of output, as they are saying that each test case output in new line, the max length of the subarray. So we have to give the maximum length of the subarray. And the maximum length of the subarray here, if I say the first one is 0, 1, 0, 1. So the maximum length here is 4, as you can see here. And assuming here is like this, so which is 0, 0, 1, 0, 0 in the next test case. And the output of this next test case is 2. Okay. So again, you have to give what they are asking. Given an array, you have to time complete the function which returns the size of the largest subarray. Largest subarray. So what is the largest subarray with equal number of zeros and equal number of 1? For example, here the total number of 1's are 1 and 2. The total number of zeros are 1 and 2. Okay. Now for this particular case, the total number of 1 is only 1, so number of zeros also should also be 0. Either you can take this subarray or you can take this subarray. Now assuming that we have the input as 1 1 0 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 0 1. Okay, now if I take a subarray with equal number of 1s and equal number 0. So here 1 2 3 4. So 1 2 3 4. So 4 zeros and 4 1s are there, and again 1 and 0. So that means here again 5 1s and 5 0s are there. Then if I take this one, now for this one there is 1 0 should be there, it is there. But if I take this one, for this one there is no zeros are there. Okay, so if I take this subarray, now this can be a subarray which is having the largest length, but apart of this there may be more subarrays are possible. Then you have to find out all the possible subarrays here, and in all those possible subarrays you have to find the subarray which is having the maximum length. Okay, and I hope that you understood the problem. Now take your time and solve this problem, and then come back to the next video where I'll just explain you how to solve this problem is the most efficient time possible, right? Most efficient time, because and here we are expecting the time complexity to be order of n. I'm already telling you the time complexity is order of n. This is a hint to you that you can solve the problem. Obviously again you can solve the problem, but you have to solve this problem in order of n as the time complexity. Okay, now let us move on to the solution videos of this problem. Okay.